Hi everyone, today I'm in Niagara Falls, Ontario, and we're checking out the Niagara Power Station. This one's a little bit interesting for me because I actually used to work for the hydroelectric company in Vancouver, British Columbia. And so I know a little bit about hydroelectric power generation, and pretty cool to see this historic power station. Let's go explore. Right now we're at the top of the falls. And there's Horseshoe Falls right over there. Beautiful little walkway here. We've got the Niagara River over on the left, and over on the right is the Niagara Parks Power Station. There's a plaque here commemorating the WM Rankin Operating Station. Built between 1901 and 1905, it was the first powerhouse on the Canadian side to produce electrical energy for commercial use and sale outside of Niagara Falls. Let's head in the Niagara Parks Power Station. So the Niagara Parks Power Station was open for 100 years. It opened in 1905 and it used the power from Horseshoe Falls to create hydroelectric power. It supplied power to the surrounding areas of Fort Erie, Ontario, Buffalo, and New York until the plant was decommissioned in 2006. When it opened in 1905, it was said to be one of the most advanced hydroelectric stations in the world. Electrical energy was generated by the force of the water from the Niagara River, which would drop 180 feet before traveling through a 2,000-foot tunnel, which emptied out at the base of the falls. In fact, just last year, Niagara Parks opened that tunnel to visitors, so you can experience the falls in a whole new way. So right now, we are here in the power station, and this is actually going to take you 180 feet down. Along this tunnel, 600, 1200, 1800, and out to the end tunnel right there. 2,000 feet underground and out to the edge of the river. In 2009, the power station was gifted to Niagara Parks, and this incredible structure was given new life as a tourist attraction. And it showcases an incredible work of engineering and the role that the power station played in the history of Niagara Falls. Here's one of the power station's original elevator cars. It says these were notorious for breaking down, and then when they were being fixed, that the workers would have to ride to the top of the elevator cab and complete a series of drop tests to test the 100-year-old braking technology before people would be allowed to ride it again. This is a portable welder used to generate an electric arc which melted and fused metals together. It was used to repair power station equipment. Of course, Tesla helped pave the way for modern hydroelectric power generation. Originally working with and eventually competing with his future rival Thomas Edison. And this is a historic voltage tester. Pretty giant. It says it was used to test the alternating current and electrical potential between conductors. It used three oil-filled transformers to decrease the voltage of the generator output and run the incandescent bulbs inside. Of course, this thing is as tall as I am. Nowadays, that would be a much smaller device. And this is kind of cool. I don't know the name for it, but there's a moving bridge or walkway up over the top here. It's got a cart where I guess somebody could sit, as well as a hook and crane for different repairs that needed to be done. And the cool thing is that it's actually on tracks and wheels. If you look over on the left hand side there, you can see that it's on wheels and it could move up and down the entire length of this gigantic powerhouse. Some old photos from construction and operation of the power station. And back here, hidden away, an old phone booth. You don't see many of those anymore. These were used to communicate throughout the plant if they needed to signal up and down through the different floors. It's an original power station phone. This is a very early fire extinguisher on a cart. It's got wheeled cart. It says it was quick and easy transportation in case of emergencies that could happen throughout the power station. And it was designed for use on flammable liquids and electrically energized fires. There are also some interactive exhibits to teach you a little bit about how the power station works.
So let's imagine a typical day at the station. We've got four generators running. Suddenly, we get a call over the phone.
We need more power,
they're telling us. Whenever we need more power, we need to bring another generator online. Usually, we're prepared for this. And we have a generator spinning away. All we have to do is add that special ingredient, magnetism. Do you think we use AC or DC current to create our magnetic field? If you think it's AC, move the switch on your screen to the right. If you think it's DC, move it to the left. Quick, quick, you've got 4 seconds to answer. Exactly, DC current. And in this station, we make all our direct current with exciter unit. An exciter unit has two parts, a motor on the front end that rotates a DC generator on the back end.
Wait for the motor to start spinning up.
As soon as that motor is turning, the DC generator starts spinning and producing some DC power. But I think you've had enough excitement for now. If you hang around, maybe I'll teach you something else. But for now, stay in control.
I might be wrong, but I think that's the actual clock from the clock tower in Hill Valley up there. I could be mistaken. Here's one of the turbines that was used in the power station. This would have been rotated by the pressure of the water passing through it. Pretty giant. It's about 6 feet across, maybe? Let's look out the power station windows and out to the river. And there's the falls over on the left. At least I can see the mist from the falls over on the left. And the water would be diverted here for power generation, and the rest of it would head over the falls. Here's another cool area. Look at this. Right beside the gift shop, you can actually see the water coming in from the river. A bunch of fish hanging out down there. They seem to be pretty happy. I guess now this is a still pool, but back in the day, this probably would have been one of the intakes, I'm guessing, for the power station. I'm such an electricity nerd. They have such a cool collection of power-related items in the gift shop. There's a Nikola Tesla t-shirt. Nikola Tesla quote mugs. Coffee and science. It's a good combination. Here's another Nikola Tesla t-shirt. Someday I'll harness that power. Nikola Tesla. This is awesome. To invent, you need a good imagination and a pile of junk. That's a quote from Thomas Edison. If that's not geeky enough, we got a whole bunch of science ties here. Your Nikola Tesla, King of Lightning tie. And who doesn't want your Nikola Tesla socks? They definitely have some cool merch here. Some Niagara Parks Power Station shirts and water bottles. Even a picture calendar, that's a pretty good deal. I always liked these solar radiometers. I always thought those were pretty cool as a kid. You'd see those little, the flywheel in there spinning, powered by solar. I thought that was pretty cool. You can even take your own little Nikola Tesla home with you. So thanks for checking this out with me. Remember to keep exploring. Until next time, it's time to exit through the gift shop.